Say hi to everybody, Ruby. It's been a while since Ruby's got her 5 minutes of fame on the YouTube.
I think she has a cold or something. She's been like shaking a lot and sniffling. It's kind of sad. So we're keeping an extra good eye on her, making sure she's snuggled up in a blanket. Are you sick? Or are you just trying to get attention?
Good morning, you guys. What's up? I'm looking a little crusty right now. Just woke up. Had to get up early today. We're getting two meals in before we go and train today with Kenny KO. I'm linking up with the boy today. He wanted to get a lift in and figured it'd be a fun change of pace. I like Kenny a lot. He's funny as fuck. I'm feeling good. I'm about to eat my first meal. It's 320 grams of egg whites, two whole eggs. And then I got 80 grams of oats, 110 grams of blueberries, and 20 grams of peanut butter, some nut butter. I had someone asking me about what supplements I take recently, so I take quite a bit. Honestly, where are my fish oils? I kind of go overkill on the supplements. You definitely don't need to take as many as I do. The ones that I'd recommend, like everyone should take, is obviously creatine, fish oils, B12, probably vitamin D if you live in a area where you're not getting enough like naturally through the sunlight. It's just good to supplement it. What else, Kat? What else is like a solid one that everyone should take? Vitamin C obviously is a solid one too. Tedka is another good one. It's like liver support and it helps with digestion. Not something that you necessarily need, but it's a solid one. NAC's fire. They were trying to ban this during the COVID situation. But this is like really, really good for cardiovascular health. I can't explain it, but like I've heard that from many people, so I decided I'm gonna start taking it. B12, this is one that everyone should be taking. It just helps support your energy levels and it helps convert food into energy. Vitamin D3, obviously, you gotta get that shit. If you really wanna be quality with it, get the shit with coconut oil, because if you get cheap vitamin D3 and fish oils, any kind of pill that's like a fish oil or any kind of pill that has an oil in it, a lot of time they'll use like shitty oils, like vegetable oils and stuff. So I try and get stuff with coconut oil. A good quality fish oil is something that you should always take. Magnesium citrate, it's good for nervous system health. And now we're getting into the stuff that I've been recommended to take that I don't really fucking know why, but I take it anyways. I don't even know how to say that. How do you say that? I don't know, it supports a healthy cholesterol. Some of these Kyle recommended me to take, so I'm taking everything Kyle told me. Super K, this is ketamine. But yeah, that's what I mean by go a little overkill with the supplements. It's all good stuff, it's all quality stuff, but some of it I don't really understand. Like I said, you don't need to be doing all that. You get a good fish oil, some vitamin D3, all that stuff that I mentioned earlier, like, you're solid.
Nino from The Ohio State University.
The University of Nino.
The University of Swim, Washington.
First round pick overall. We're like NDSU out there in Swim. We're just fucking producing athletes.
North Dakota State.
Slap dog, baby.
All right, we're going on a little field trip today. So we're linking up with Kenny KO, like I said earlier, but we're also going to a new gym that I've never been to in Vegas, just to get a little change of scenery. This isn't gonna be a permanent thing or anything. I'm in love with the gym we've been training at right now. Kilo Club is like one of my favorite gyms in Vegas, if not my favorite. It's just so quiet and low key, but I'm excited. It's always fun checking out new gyms, so that's where we're headed.
Let's go, Kenny KO.
I don't know, man. We're in like a Walmart parking lot right now.
Not that there's anything wrong with Walmart, but you know, we're used to a little bit the finer things in life ever since we've been going to Kilo, so.
Nah, we can't switch up though. Back to our roots. No.
Kenny's 21 minutes late, man. I'm not surprised.
Kenny.
We're probably harassing people about their natty status. All right, coach, what do you got me doing today?
All
700 milligram of, all right, tranacetate pre-workout. We just went 700 here, 700 here.
All right, so technically, like I was saying earlier, this is the same push day that we did last week, but we're gonna mix it up a little bit because me, Kenny, and Johnny are gonna be working out together. Just chasing the pump.
Is there?
A lot of volume still though, so should be a good time.
Post a video and it's like from the side, the girls are like, keep growing the mullet.
Dude, it's
the girls ran into the mullet right now. Oh,
okay. I need to grow a mullet then.
It's been a long time, but the mullets are finally back, bro. Yeah, Nino, you know, you need to get one.
Oh,
you'd be like a tequache.
Yeah, true.
I liked it.
Feeling good. Now we can hop over to Smith.
It gave me two big effects.
Well, like, I'll see what Nino wants to do. I'd rather do Smith machine incline, but we could also do dumbbells. Like I said, I'm with the boys today, so
it was
trying to get in all the work that we need to, but just having fun.
So picky about the way I'm setting up on these, bro.
Fuck! Get that shit up!
Fuck sash, how strong is this? Oh, this is like fucking so much lighter than what we're used to. It's like I'm playing with a fucking toy. Oh, this is nice.
That's what social media is about. You just gotta like Photoshop in the video of like four more plates on there.
Everyone's doing it, man.
Yeah. Everyone's doing these days.
Damn, I've never used
bro, this. Bro, Kenny, you're looking fucking huge, Kenny. I've been seeing some art.
Kenny has that grown man muscle.
The mature Kenny. Muscle?
Yeah, he's
from 45.
It's good.
Boy.
Good.
That
looks
light.
Yeah, it feels good. It feels light.
We kind of look like twins right now.
Twinsies.
Yeah, get this.
I want to grow the sash.
It's kind of there.
I didn't shave it today. Yeah, yeah. Dude, 2 days. Only 2 days. Only 2 days to grow.
Your nips out.
Tough one.
Yes, sir.
Come on, Neil. There you go.
Yeah. Woo! Saucy, bro.
God damn.
He's like,
yeah, this is the, oh shit.
Okay.
So it's
are you noticing a difference?
Not, I haven't like, I think like 2 weeks.
This is your opportunity to come clean.
2 weeks.
Сержантом возглавить операцию.
That. Yeah, these feel so much better.
Like, I'm not trying to go to the Olympia.
You know what the weight is for your height? Oh, wait, it'd be open, right?
Yeah, everyone's telling me. Well, the only reason why I'm asking is because, like,
it depends how you stack up against, I guess, like, the other people that your height range.
I don't know. I guess it's hard to ask. I was just wondering what you thought.
I mean, at least based on your look, I think you could, for sure.
Maybe. Because I don't know if I can go classic. Because everyone I talked to is like, you gotta go open. Jay was like, you gotta go open. Like, yeah, he's like, you can't go classic. And I'm like, I know. After he told me that, I was like, okay.
Yes. But, size though, like for doing open, most people don't, you know.
But the issue that I think about with there is like, some of these guys aren't afraid to push the needle like hella, you know what I'm saying? So like, I wonder how much I'm gonna have to fucking.
But you kind of already got the base though, where I don't think you'd really have to push it too hard unless you're going like hardcore pro.
Like trying to go.
You know, like in these initial shows, and then probably even.
I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, but like someone like you, even if they do push the needle, like you don't have to and you can still beat them. Like the top doesn't go as hard, I've heard, like on steroids. Like the elite bodybuilders, like genetic wise, like they don't actually do as much steroids as you think. Like C-Bump, for example.
Some of them do.
Some of them do. Some of them do for sure.
But I don't know. Like,
but like where you're at right now, especially.
That's what I'm saying.
I think so, yeah. I mean, I have no idea.
Probably yeah. What you're even doing right now. Like, I think you got the size based on like what I saw back when I competed.
You just have to dry out, really.
The fucking 2 weeks in, baby.
You just gotta bring your chest up a little bit.
I do. I just gotta get lean. I gotta see what's under there. I
should have seen it.
There you go, special K.
The K's for ketamine.
Don't get it twisted.
That's my secret before my workout.
Easy. Backflip.
Bradley's coming. Bradley Casaberry's coming, baby.
Shoulders, baby. I'm grinding them right now. I get these puppies to pop a little bit more. Lean out a little bit. You got a tattoo, your first tattoo?
The tribal.
Okay.
The douchebag tribal when I was like 18.
Oh, the
douchebag. I would always, when people would ask me, like, what does it mean? I would just come up with some random shit on the spot every single time.
Yeah.
That's funny. Yeah, I'm always curious.
That's funny, you got a tribal tattoo.
What's that? That is like.
I can't even see it really now. That kind of just goes
like in there. But when that was like the only one I had at one point, I was like, I look back and I'm like,
you're like, God damn it.
Yeah. No. I think everyone's got those tattoos though where they're like.
EKO, always a pleasure, brother.
My man.
We gotta do it more often. We always hang out with Kenny.
Honestly, dead ass though, these two are like some of the only guys that fuck with in the industry.
Yeah,
what else you guys are watching are pretty fake. I know a lot of these dudes, these are two real dudes.
Holding it down in Vegas, baby.
2 weeks in, baby. 2 weeks and one workout in of the cut.
feeling good, feeling happy. Like I've been saying, guys, I'm really focused on this cut. I was telling Kenny today, I know I keep saying it, but this is like genuinely, I feel like in my life, like the most like locked in I've been on, all right, I'm gonna cut, I'm gonna do a show. Cause I've been thinking about doing a show for a long time, but like I never really was sold on it. I've always kind of been like iffy with bodybuilding, but I have personal reasons why I want to do these shows now. And I feel like I'm just like, I'm happy because I have a goal that I'm working towards and I feel like, okay, I'm taking steps in the right direction, working hard every single day. I don't want to rush the process. You can't rush the process, you know? I feel like a lot of people, especially in today's age in the fitness industry, like social media game, it's like, bro, everyone wants quick results. No such thing as quick results. I mean, not without consequences, you know what I'm saying? So just taking my time, focusing, being patient, listening to Kyle, fucking trying to work hard every single day for you guys for P-Way. Appreciate you guys. I know it's a quick video, quick little vlog. I'll crank out more. I got some, I don't want to say exciting stuff coming up in the next couple months, because like I said, bro, I'm just here. Like, this is what I'm doing this summer, is I'm fucking training with Nino, hanging out with Kat, hanging out with Ruby, trying to get ready to go fucking fuck shit up on a show, on a stage. Word to your mother.
Yeah. Well, that'd be delayed gratification.
That's the name of the game. But yeah, I'm sure that I'll travel. I want. There's definitely a couple of people that I'd love to like link up with and shoot a video with. But I'm not gonna be reaching for anything for at least the next couple of months until I'm like, okay, man, I'm really like in a place where I'm happy with my physique and I'm about ready to start a prep. So appreciate you guys. Love you guys. P-Way the only way. I'll see you guys again real soon.